What's up, guys? We are back for another Ark Survival Evolved, and hopefully my sound is fixed this time. Last time, I'd gotten a new webcam for that other video for the 1-Up box, and it, somehow took over all my sound settings and screwed up everything, so it should all be back to normal again, so hopefully that's the case. So, anyways, I still haven't put any lights up in here, we really need to, but, that's not our focus for today. What our focus is going to be is, let's get the last couple things named. Let's see, we got Toxic Beak for him. And then, I went with, Joan Frost. There. And we've got, Liftmaster, which you guys will see why in a bit. Let's see, what else were we naming? The Bat I haven't really named yet. The Beavers are Dirty Beaver, Toxic Beaver, Hot Beaver, Cold Beaver. And yes, those are all vagina jokes. We went with Bloodhorn and Icehorn. Cobalt Crusher. And we've got Dirty Claw, Ice Claw. White Fang. And, Oh, yeah. This is one of my favorite grass clippings. I love that. And, I forgot to name the Alpha Sabretooth. I think there's some good suggestions. If not, just in case, throw a few good ones down. And then, let's see. What else we got? Albert, Allie, and Al. And then, Janice. I'm not sure really how to say that, but it's a suggestion. And we went with Bloodspine for this guy here. And I think that covers the names we did. What we do need is a name for the Dodoraxes, the Bionics, because it looks like, no. What are you doing all the way over there? Well, I don't know what he's fishing for over there, but, we need a name for both of them. And then we need, A-Queen, hi, you aren't supposed to be here. We need a name for our female Dodorex. And then we also need names for the dragons, now that they stick around. So, go ahead and resubmit your names for that. And then, what is going on over here? Like, I've tried to reduce spawns in here so much. And we start getting stupid spawns. Whiplash is still missing. I've put foundations around everywhere, but it looks like a few spaces, like right here, there's not too much. But yeah, I spam foundations everywhere, and that seems to have cut down most all of the spawns. I also put a inner gate around, and this inner gate is just to protect the dinos pretty much, and then out there is whatever else I want to build whenever I feel like it. But this is kind of like a protection thing just around everyone here, and then I've set most of them passive so they don't all freak out everywhere. There's something wrong with Gaia. I can't ride it, and it's not wearing a saddle, but it is wearing a saddle. I don't really know how to explain that. It's very weird. It's quite annoying, actually. And, yeah, see, look, now we're still getting spawns. This is incredibly irritating. I don't know what's going on. But we're going ahead and close, or actually, no, we don't want to close that up. We want to go in there first. Or not. Okay. Well, we'll come over here real quick. And so, I don't know if you saw this ramp here, but the ramp is basically so that the titans can get out. And I've noticed wild dinosaurs tend to, like, hit it and kind of be like, ooh, that's not nice. And they kind of, like, just back right off of it like that galley did just now. But this is, yeah, the way for the titans to get out. I'll probably put some turrets on the ends, just in case. And I'll probably be putting some turrets up and about and around here as well. But today, we're going to be building a dock for our sea creatures. And then we'll also, customizing a trophy slash living room. So, let's go ahead and head up there. See, like, right now one of my guys is getting hurt, I think. It's freaking annoying. Yeah, see, it's just an ant or a terror bird or something, and, I don't really want to leave someone a wander, just because that tends to never work out very well. But anywho, we've got this ramp set up now, and this is going up into what will be our trophy slash bedroom, so we're going to have the bed kind of, like, up in here, and then a bunch of trophies and all sorts of cool stuff like that. And then we've actually connected these. You gotta crouch, that's the only compromise I had to make. But it connects beautifully here, here. And then this one's like the gigantic one. But it makes its way all the way to here. So there's a bit of a lip. This one's not exactly so pretty, but I don't even know if we're even going to use these spaces. So we'll see what we do with them. If you guys have ideas for the other spaces here. But before we get working on this, we're going to get the deck laid out. So we're going to go ahead and head on down. I think I passed the door. No. Yes. There it is. Still getting my bearings. Okay, so now, let's get started. Can we just kind of, like... yeah, nope. Dang it. Come on. Alright, fine. I give up. We'll take the door. Alrighty. Now, actually, do I have... Crap, we needed a foundation in our inventory. Okay. Well, actually, we can just... Just gonna do that. And I think we're gonna take our dock and extend it out this way. So I'd like to kind of just make it like that, maybe? Yeah, that seems alright. And then, away we go, pretty much. Oh, now we can pick that up. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. I think that's about nice. So that's 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, beautiful. Alright, so now we're just gonna get this all filled in. Do like a little fishing hole kind of thing. And let's see. Yeah, I think we'll do like a little fishing hole there in the middle kind of a deal. And then basically now we just need to do like parking spaces. So let's see, how deep is the water here? Deep enough for the pleasy, so let's see, we'll go out that way. Oh, and looks like we're gonna need some more ceilings. Let's go ahead and set up our ramps. Hello? Huh. It's obstructed. Well, that's annoying. I guess we're gonna have to use regular ramps on that one. Alright, well, what we can do is, just purely for visuals, I wanted to add some pillars so it kind of looks like an actual dock. Oops. Can we... Really? That's really getting annoying. And again, like I said, this is purely for visual. That's yes. Can we? All right. What's going on here? It's a tail. It's a tail. No, it's entire dinosaur. Okay. And lastly, alright, so we've got our dock pillars there started up. I'd like to maybe, yeah, there we go. Oops. Stick one there, just for appearances, and I guess we'll move it there and then get rid of that one. There we go. All right, well, we are gonna go get some more materials and we'll be right back. Okay, guys, we're back, and yeah, okay. Corrected structures never lets us down. So we got that. Also, I realized I think this is a bit short, so we'll keep, the rain stopped. The fishing hole there, but we're gonna go out more. Whoa. Okay, so we got that set up. Now we're gonna go ahead and put our first one here. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Let's do and then what we want to do is we want the ramps to in. There we go. Alright, so, like, for instance, then we could take Slam Dunk over here. And, docking them is not very easy. Especially when there's stuff in the way. Alright, so they're actually significantly larger. Let's alter this. This is why you work on things, right? So you can alter them. So we're going to Oh. Not what you meant to do either. Okay, there we go. Let's go ahead and get... Let's see, what's in the way over here? Riptide is? Okay. I'm gonna swim over here. And let's get back to Slam Dunk here. We can crank a little bit more points into... Okay. So we're gonna go ahead and do, like, a little circle. Come up to the surface. And we can... No? No? We're not going to? Is this... You're gonna play this game with me right now? This was... Going to, like... there we go. Park it. Boom! Look at that. That's what I'm talking about right there. So anyways, yeah. I'm gonna go ahead and kind of do some more to the docks here, and then we'll be back. Alright guys, the morning sun is coming up, and we've got our dock pretty much finished, so we got some nice railings around, we've got some feeding troughs set up around here, and we've got our, like, fishing holes. So what I'm gonna do is, I don't know if we can fish from benches, so I'm not sure if that's something or not. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and put, like, a bench here, and, like, I guess we can't put a bench there, but we'll put, like, a... bench here. Okay, we're gonna have to move this guy. Alright. Come on. Away we go. Okay. Let's see. Bench here. And a bench here. And then I thought we could put, like, a one here, one here, and then chairs. For fishing. That. Okay. I think that pretty much does it. I think I might just put one over here, because why not? We'll just have it. Oh! That scared me. I'm gonna be 100% honest with you guys. That legitimately scared the balls out of me. Yeah, I put, like, right there for fishing. And then I realized we were missing a ramp right here. Oh, okay. That. Let's pick you back up. Alright. So, Pancake, you need some levels. We aren't going to make the mistake we have in the past, though, and we're just going to move you over here where it's a little safer. And where there's food. And then, let's go ahead and move this guy. Let's try this again. That speed that just... Oh, makes it so hard. There we go. Nice. So we got him parked there. And then, let's see. Let's get Riptide parked. This is gonna be in the way. Let's go ahead and pick up that. Pick up that. Pick up that. Okay. Let's we can park Grimms in, I guess. This is gonna be difficult. This is gonna be very difficult. These are kind of things that don't want to be parked. Alright, I think that's about as close as we're getting to it being parked anywhere here. We're definitely will have to make like a wider section. But hey, he's right there and you can kind of just jump onto him, so that works. Now we should be able to move Riptide now. So let's do a little flip around here. And there we go. Alright. So we got a parking spot there. And then Tron is gonna be incredibly difficult to move. The sheer fact of how much he moves. Yeah, I think that's about as close as we're getting to parking him there. I am not an expert creature parker. And I guess that's Meaty's Mozo over there. Deadpool or whatever his name is. So I guess he's bumming rent off me. And there we have it, guys. We've got our dock fully built, and it's looking pretty nice. Good place to fish. Got some park critters around, and doing pretty good. So let's go ahead and I guess we'll get ready to make some stuff for the bedroom there. Alright guys, so we're back and we're gonna get some stuff started up here. I'm pretty excited to get it all set up. Now, lighting is going to be a crazy bad issue, I noticed. can't really do anything about it, but ceiling lamps and shit don't attach. Unless you do something like this, and even then they don't really. You have to actually place them from above. It's really, really wonky. Yeah. What we're gonna do is we're gonna do a couple of wall lamps, basically, and that's how we're gonna go with it, and I'm gonna see if our electricity reaches out here. So this is something I'm very curious about. Wow, it does. Okay. Alright. Well then. Let's stick one here. And stick one here for now. Alright, hopefully that gives us enough electricity for stuff. Yeah, alright. Seems alright. Yeah, and these guys are from the little steampunk, these are little steampunk lamps. Wall lamps. And, they give off a yellow light, but, like, I'm not sure I really care for the yellow light all that much, because it kind of sets a depressing tone, but it's a lot better than the blinding fluorescence of pretty much every other light in every fucking mod in the entire game of Ark. Sorry for the language there, but, like, really, I'm just, like, please, people, can we make some lamps that aren't complete awful? So, and up here, special for the room. We're gonna light it up there. And there. Okay. And then we're gonna grab our bed. And stick it right in the middle. Beautiful. Rename. Germs room. Okay. Nice. Now the next thing I want to do is put like a little footlocker up here. I think we'll just put it like right up against there. It's a little small storage box for us to put some things in. And then next we've got a couple of different benches here. So we've got this guy here, which is armor skins, and we've got this one here, which is like decorations. So we're gonna add that there. And then I think trophies, since we can't really attach anything to the inner part of this, I think what we're gonna do is start with this as a start starting point. That's gonna be the dragon god. And then we've got one, two, three, and four, and then one, two, three. And four. All right. There's that blue one that's always green. And oh, did I goof? I think I did. Yeah, because this is supposed to be the big blue one. So we'll stick that one there. Yeah, that's how I want to set up. That looks cool. And then, yeah, that'll be Dragon Trophy Head. And then these will be all the other ones. Beautiful. So we got our trophy set up. Like that. Shows we killed all the wardens. And, yeah, so I guess now we're going to jump into a little bit of what we're going to make decoration-wise. And this is a brand new mod from Eco. And you can just put all sorts of really cool stuff. That throne chair. Mounted angler, mounted bear, mounted dodo, mounted dunkleo. There's just tons of dinosaurs. Dino torches, mounted lit skulls. You've got flags, which are really cool looking. There's different beds. So I think what we mostly need here is going to be hide and metal ingots and wood. Okay, let's go get that stuff. And we'll go upstairs. I wasn't sure if I saw it, but you always end up needing fiber for something, so I don't know if we'll need any pelt. I'm just gonna grab some. Hide. Whoops, we passed the wood. And what was the other thing? Oh, metal. Okay. Perfect. Perfect. And then there is this other trophy maker right here, but like we need a ton of stuff we don't really have much of, so we'll leave that for a different day. But let's go ahead and make some of these. So whoops. I'm gonna go around that. Make a nice little table. Tape. Hello? Table? Table. Okay, tables don't want to be crafted. Don't know what green box is, but we're going to find out. Wall shelf. See how that turns out. How about this throne? What do we got here? Fancy books. I like how butterfly and deer pictures names are switched there. Birdcage? Sure, why not? Angler on a wall. Bear, dodo rex, dunk, mammoth. Yeah, these are cool. Not anchor. Ship wheel, that's cool. Ooh, polar bear rug. Let's do a bear rug. And let's do one of these lit up skulls. We got all sorts of fun stuff to play with here. Okay, first of all, let's see what this is. I don't even know what this is. Is it just a planter? Oh! It's like a window planter. Oh, that's really cool. Of course, green box. Makes sense. Okay, so we got like a little window planter. That's neat. I like that. I like that a lot. And so the shelf, I'm assuming, works very similar. Same idea. Sticks out really wide, though. Huh. That's neat. We can place stuff on, I guess. Let's see, what do these books do? Yeah, they're just books that chill around, okay. Well, put some books out. Let's do some paintings. Oh, I see, they're like... That's neat. That's really cool. I like that. Alright, well, let's just stick our chair somewhere. I was thinking we could have, like, a nice, like, viewing space. Yeah, we can look down at our dinos. That's pretty baller. Let's check out the bird cage. Oh, it's like a mini Argent! And it's animated. That is... Oh, that is so freaking cool. I feel like we need, like, a lamp right next to... Whoop. Right next to our chair. It's like a reading lamp. Or something. Oh, there's no power. Alright, we're gonna need some more nodes up here. What else we've got? We've got this rug. Poor squished bear. That's really awesome, though. I love it. Let's take, like, water creatures and put them in one area. So, let's say... Angler can go here. And then, let's see, dunk head here. That's cool. And then let's put the Sarco, like, right there. That's cool. I like it. Alright, let's do some, like, mammals. Let's do these three. And for this way. So let's do polar bear. Mammoth. Nice. And regular bear. Those are sick. I like it. I like it a lot. Dodo Rex, Rex, Rex. So, Dodo Rex will hang up right here. We got ourselves a nice T-Rex head. Nice. And we've got the big skull. Ooh, it has like a fire effect inside of it. That's really cool. That's really cool. And we can post a trike up right there. That's neat. These are really cool. And I just realized that the angler gel on the angler glows. That's pretty awesome. I like that a lot. And these plant boxes are neat. I like it. It's really nice. I think I might go ahead and make one more of those. Actually, we'll do four. For some reason, the tables just won't craft. That's so weird. Hmm. Oh, we missed the Megaloceras somehow. Let's get another bearskin rug. The other kind. Huh. Yeah, Megaloceras. Oh, the coffin bed worked. That's a little creepy. Granted vampire. Yet. What? There we go. And then put another one here. Nice. I like that. That's awesome. Let's stick our other bearskin rug right before you go up to the room. And then, let's see, the Megaloceras needs a mounting area. Boom. That is nice. Oh. That is pretty awesome. And I think that's what we're gonna call the episode, guys. So, thanks for watching. As always, don't forget to click that like button, and we will see you guys next time.